my journey into directing really started as photography. And I, in my early years, got connected to photography because of a camera that my father gave me when I was 14. And I really just took off at that and went to art school and studied photography. I really have had my whole career as a photographer. And for me, it's all been about storytelling. And I found as my career evolved and my shooting style evolved that I was directing constantly. I'm like talking to talent all the time. I'm directing the set, I'm directing the lighting. I'm constantly in motion with this. And at one point I realized, this is like shooting a film. This is like shooting a commercial. And the light bulb went off and I said, that's really where I want this career to evolve into. So that was it. I started pursuing video direction and motion. And of course, it gives you so many more ways to tell a story. You get to use sound and you get to use music and you get to use editing and you get all this interaction with the talent, which I love. Of course, in the end, it all comes down to story. The most challenging part of moving to directing is really coordinating the symphony of elements that are involved in video production. There's so many elements to consider, from locations and movements and cuts and edits and sound and all these things that work together to create a mood. But it's really challenging. And that doesn't mean I don't like it. I love it. I love the whole thing. But that's really where my energy gets peaked, to make sure all the elements are right. Of course, I also surround myself with some really talented people to help with all these things. The big reward for me is the day that we're shooting. Once I actually get behind the camera and start shooting, that's when I can breathe easy. I just relax, I have fun, I get to interact with my subjects, I get to see a set come to life. All this planning just unfolds on the day of the shoot, and that to me is exhilarating. That's when I have the most fun. But the true reward comes when you see the finished piece, all edited, music and sound is in there. And if it's successful, I really feel that emotion that I envisioned at the very beginning of the planning stage. And seeing other people who are moved by this piece, however small or big it is, that's the ultimate reward. My dream assignment is to travel the world and photograph and film and tell the stories of change makers. People who have impacted the lives of other people on this planet, that's what really gets me excited. My partner and I co-create a digital publication called Best Self Magazine in the space of holistic health and conscious living. And my work there has really impacted what I want to do with my directing and my photography. So to have the opportunity to travel, to find these people and tell their stories, whether their stories are on a small scale of impacting their family or their community or their tribe, or on a grand scale of shifting a nation or the world, that's what I want to do. I want to tell their stories, bring them to life. My mind works at 100 miles an hour. It's constantly on. I've got ideas going through my mind all the time. I do turn off occasionally in the evening, but for the most part, I can't wait to wake up in the morning, and I'm really not too excited to go to bed because I've got 100 ideas all the time. If people ask me what's on my mind right now, I say, how long you got? I consider myself super lucky to be doing what I want in a creative field where I will never be bored. It's the most exciting thing in the world. You know, people like to ask, what would you like to come back as? There's so much learning that goes on in this life. It's such a wonderful experience, but I have to say, if I had the opportunity to come back as something else again, honestly, I would like to come back exactly as I am, but with all this knowledge already under my belt. I'd love to continue this learning experience and not have to make the mistakes that I've already made all over again. I'm not really attached to very much in this life, but the one thing I would want to have with me if I had to flee this house would be this letter, this framed letter that's next to me on my desk, that's from my father. And in that letter, it's a short handwritten note where my father basically releases me from the family expectations of taking over our family's machine tool business in the rusty Midwest town that I grew up in. He frees me to go off and pursue photography. He frees me to do what I want to do in my life and not feel encumbered by all these strings of the family. For that, I'm grateful every day.